So now we'll look into the how to find out the sum of the nth term in arithmetic progression. So all the numbers in a series find out the sum up to 10th term, 20th term or nth term. Okay, so sum of nth term of arithmetic progression series equal to n by 2 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay, n is the term, a is the first term, and d is the difference, common difference. Okay, so suppose a series I have 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. Okay, fine. Now I want to find out the sum of the sixth number. Okay, so our n will be the 6, 6 by 2, 2a, 2 into a is 1, plus n minus 1, n is the 6 minus 1 into d. What is the d? D is 3 minus 1, 2, 5 minus 3, 2, 7 minus 5, 2. So our d will be 2 into 2. So 6 by 2 equal to 3, 2 into 1 equal to 2, plus 6 minus 1 equal to 5 into 2, 10. So 3 into 12. So 36 is the sum of up to 6 number of this series. Okay, so if we know the last term, okay, or suppose 6 term is 36. Okay, so 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th. Okay, so here sum is coming 36. Okay, up these numbers, up to 6 number. Okay, so 11 is the last number of this series. So we can find out through one more formula, n by 2. Here we can say a 2a, we can write a plus a plus n minus 1 into d. We know that n by 2, okay, a this much is nothing but the nth term. So nth term we can represent with L. Okay, so now we can write here n by 2, n is the 6 by 2, a is 1 plus L is the nth term we find out just now, so 11. So 6 by 2 equal to 3 into 39. Sorry, this is 12, so this is 36. So 6 by 2 into 12 equal to 36. So in this way and this formula also we are getting the same value. So this is the way to find out the sum of the nth term of the arithmetic progression series. Up to any number we can find out the sum. Thank you very much. Hello everyone, I am Ajit from Catalyst Class. So here today we will discuss about the arithmetic progression. So what is the arithmetic progression? Arithmetic progression is the series of the number in which each number can be added by the constant number so that we can get the next number. Okay, so how we can define the, like in a, we will take one example for the arithmetic progression. So suppose there is the first term I am taking like 2. Okay, and the common difference, suppose I am considering the 5. So how the arithmetic progression sequence will come, like series will come: 2 is the first number, then next number will be 2 plus 5 equal to 7, then next number is 7, is 7 plus 5 equal to 13, and so on. So in this way we can make the series. Okay, because the first number is a, first term is a equal to 1, and common difference d equal to 5. So the series will be 2, then 2 plus 5 7, 7 plus 5 13 plus 5 18. In such a way our series will come. Okay, so suppose there is a series is given like 2 7 13 18 and so on. So suppose we need to find out the what will be the fifth term. Okay, so this is the first term, second term, third, fourth, and I want to find out the fifth term. Okay, so how to find out the fifth term? So if you see the simply, so difference is d, so 2 plus 5 7 7 plus 5 equal to 13 13 plus 5 equal to 18 18 plus 5 equal to 23. We can find out easily. Okay, but if this series number is complex and yeah, and we want to find out the 30th term or 40th term or 100th term, it will be difficult to find out in this way. So we can find out this thing through the formulas. Okay, so what is the nth term? Nth term of arithmetic progression equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So what is the a? A is the first term. N minus 1, n is the number of term and d is the common difference. Okay, so suppose I want to find out the fifth term. So what I will do here, a is our 2 plus n minus 1. I want to find fifth term, so 5 minus 1 into d equal to or 5, 7 minus 2 equal to, and 13 minus 7, 18 minus 7 equal to 5. That's the common difference. Now 2 plus 4 into 5, 2 plus 20, 22. Hi everyone, Ajit from the Catalyst class. So today we are going to discuss about the arithmetic progression. So arithmetic progression is basically it's a series of the number that can be find out with the adding the particular constant number to the previous number. Okay, so basic concept I'm going to explain about the there is concept of like just one example I'm taking 2 5 8 11 14, okay, and so on. So this is the kind of series. Okay, and here that there is a difference between these two number, first number and second number is 3, and second number and third number is 3, third number and fourth number is 3. So here the constant difference is there with their previous number, so that is called the arithmetic progression. Okay, it can be plus, it can be minus also, the series can be, we can make it like anything. Okay, by adding or subtracting any constant number to the previous number. Okay, so now there is two concept is here, the first number and the common difference between two numbers. Okay, so first number equal to 2, this is the first number, and then there is other concept is common difference equal to 5 minus 2 equal to 3, or we can take the 8 minus 5 equal to 3, similar way 14 minus 11 equal to 3. So our common difference will be 3. Okay, so suppose here this is the series is given, if I ask for the find out the 10th number. Okay, so it will be difficult because we need to add it, make it, try to find out the 5th term, 6th term, 7th and 8th, then 10th number we will able to find out. So easily we can find out through the formula. Okay, so what is the formula? Nth term a plus n minus 1 into d. So a is the first term, n is the which term we want to find out, and d is the common difference. Okay, so suppose I want to find out the 10th term. So what will be the value of a? A equal to 2, n equal to 10th term, and d equal to, what is our common difference? 3. So we will put all the value into the 10th term. 2 plus n minus 1, 10 minus 1 into 3. Then 2 plus, this is 9 into 3. 2 plus 27 equal to 29. So I can say the 10th term of our AP series equal to 29. Okay, so this way we can find out easily the particular number of the arithmetic progression series. Okay, this is the basic idea about the arithmetic progression. Now we will see some more example. Okay, so now we will solve the exercise 10.10a of arithmetic progression. So we will see the first question: which of the following sequence are in arithmetic progression? So we will take the first one: 2, 6, 10, 14, dot dot dot. So we will see the difference between first and second. This is 4, second and third, again the 4, and third and fourth, again the 4. So difference is common. So common difference is 4, and it's equal. So that we can say this is the arithmetic progression series, AP series. Okay, now you got it. The second point is the 15, 12, 9 and 6. So we'll see the difference between first and second. It's a minus 3. Second and third, so 9 minus 12 equal to minus 3 again. 9 and 6, this is again minus 3. So every time we are getting the same difference, minus 3. So this is also the AP series. Third one is saying 5, 9, 12, 18 and so on. So we will see the difference between 5 and 9. This is 9 minus 5, this is 4, 12 minus 9 equal to again 3, and here the 12 minus 18 minus 12 equal to 6. So we are getting the common difference not the same here, like 4 is coming here, 3 is coming, 6. So this is not the AP series, because AP series is like the common difference would be same. So that's the constant number. It will get add with the previous number, and that will generate the new next number. Then we can say this is the arithmetic progression series. Okay, so in this case, this is not a arithmetic progression series. Fourth one, we will see 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4 and 1 by 5. So we will try to find out the difference between first number and second number. So 1 by 3 minus 1 by 2 equal to minus 1 by 6. Here we will try to find 1 by 4 minus 1 by 3 equal to minus 1 by 12. Here again, so here first two terms we are seeing that common difference is minus 1 by 6 and here 1 by minus 1 by 12. That means this is not the, because this common difference is not same for difference of any two consecutive number. So we can say this is not the arithmetic, not an AP series number. Okay, so in this way we can solve this question. We will see the next question. So question number 2 is saying the nth term of the sequence is 2n minus 3, so find the 15th term. So it's saying about tn equal to 2n minus 3. Nth term is 2n minus 3. So what will be the 15th term? So what will be the 15th term? So n means, n is saying n equal to 15. So here it's saying n equal to 15. So what will be the 15th term? We will put it 2 into 15 minus 3. 30 minus 3, 27. So 15th term will be 27. Okay. Question number 3. If the PA term of an AP is 2P plus 3, then find the AP series. So we can say the PA term is 2P plus 3. It is asking about the, what will be the
arithmetic progression series. So we can just put the value of p equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So we can get the series. So t1 equal to, here it will be 2 into 1 plus 3 equal to 5. Again t2 equal to 2 into, we will put the value of p of equal to 2. So 2 into 2 plus 3 equal to 7. Similar way p equal to 3 we will put it. So it will be 3 into 2 plus 3, 9. So this will be the our series. Series AB 5, 7, 9 and so on. So we'll discuss about question number 4. Find the 24th term of the sequence. If this is the series, then what will be the 24th number in this sequence? Okay. So first we need to check this is the arithmetic progression or what kind of series is this. Okay, so we'll see difference between first, second, second, third and third, fourth. Here it's coming minus 2, 10 minus 12. Here it's coming 8 minus 10, minus 2, 6 minus 8, minus 2. So everywhere the common difference is same. So that means this is the arithmetic series. And in this arithmetic series, it asking about the 24th term. Somewhere it will be around 24th term. What will be the value? So we can find out, we know the nth term of AP arithmetic progression equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So A is our 12, value 12, plus N is 24 minus 1 into D. D is common difference, this minus 2. So 12 plus 23rd into minus 2. So 12 plus minus 46. Here it will be minus 4, 34. Minus 34 will be the 24th term of this arithmetic series. Okay. So we will look into the question number 5. Find the 30th term of the sequence. The sequence is given 1 by 2, 1, minus 3 by 2 and so on. So we need to find out somewhere the 30th term. Okay. What will be the value of this? So you can find out through the Tn equal to A plus N minus 1 into D formula. Okay. So what is the A? A is the first term, 1 by 2. What is the D? D is the common difference between two constitutive numbers. So here the common difference is 1 minus 1 by 2 equal to 1 by 2. Okay. Fine. And it is saying that N is the 30th term. So N is the 30th. So we can put the same value into this formula. So T 30th equal to A plus N 30 minus 1 into D is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 plus 29 by 2. It will be 30 by 2. Finally, the number will be 15. So, 15 will be the 30th term of this arithmetic progression series. Okay, we'll move to the next question. So, we will look the question number 6. Find the 100th term of the sequence underscore root 3, 2 root 3, 3 root 3 and so on so on. So it is asking about the 100th term. So we need to find out what will be the 100th term. So we know the formula Tn equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Just we need to find out the each and every term so that we can put into the formula and find out the 100th term. So what will be our A value? A value will be the first value. Underscore 3 What would be the n value? It is asking about 100 term, and what would be the d value? Common differences. So what is the difference between two consecutive number? So 2_3 minus _3 equal to _3. Okay, here we can see the difference. 3_3 minus 2_3 equal to again _3. So _3 is the common difference. Now we find out all the value. We can simply put these value into the this formula. So what will be the t 100th value equal to a _3 plus n minus 1 100 minus 1 into d is again _3. Okay, we can calculate here _3 plus 100 minus 1 99 into _3. _3 we can call 1 plus 99. This is 100_3. So 100_3 will be the 100th term. Okay, we'll move to the next question. So we will solve the question number 7. So question number 7 is saying find the 50th term of the sequence. The sequence is 1 by n, n plus 1 by n, 2n plus 1 by n, and so on. So we will see the 50th term, a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay. So our 50th term, we need to find out the value of a. A will be 1 by n first term. Okay, n is saying 50th term, it is saying find out the 50th term, so n will be the 50, and d is the common difference. So we need to find out the common difference between two consecutive number. Okay, so what will be the d? So d will be n plus 1 minus by n minus 1 by n. It will be n by n equal to 1. Here also we can find out the d equal to 2n plus 1 by n minus n plus 1 by n. Again here it will be 1. So our common difference is 1. Okay. So simply all these values we can put in this formula and find out the 50th term of this series. Okay. So 1 by n plus 50 minus 1 into d is 1. Okay, so t 50 equal to, so 1 by n plus 49. So this will be the our 50th term of this arithmetic progression series. Now we look the next question. So now we will see the question number 8. What is saying is 4 not 2 8 term of the sequence. So 4 not 2 is the term of this sequence. So it's given the particular sequence number value. So suppose this is the nth. Okay. So it is saying the nth value is 4 not 2. Okay. So what is your formula? Tn equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay. So it's saying about nth term is this. Okay. So 4 not 2 equal to a is the first term 8 plus n minus 1. It is asking the value of n. What is the nth term? We don't know the n value of n, but we know the nth term value 4 not 2. Okay, and d is the common difference between two consecutive number AP series. Okay, so 30 minus 8 equal to 5. Here 18 minus 13 equal to 5. 23 minus 18 equal to 5. So 5 will be the common difference. So here I will write to 5. So 4 not 2 minus 8 equal to n minus 1 into 5. Okay. It will be 394 equal to n minus 1 into 5. Five. plus 1. So it will be equivalent to 399 by 5. This will be the nth term. So this is the nth term, okay? So nth term is not the fraction, it's not equivalent to this, and it's not a fraction. So this is not the part of this series. So we can't find this value into this series. So here we can say, see, 402 is not the nth, not the arithmetic progression value. Okay, we will move to the next question. So now we'll solve the question number 9. Find the common difference and 99 term of the arithmetic progression series. So this is the series is given. We need to find out the common difference of this series and what will be the 99 term of this series. Okay, so common difference t equal to, we need to find out the consecutive difference between two consecutive numbers. Okay, so it will be, or we can simplify this series into the fractional part. So we can write this equivalent to 31 by 4. Here it will be 19 by 2. Here it will be 45 by 4, and so on. So we'll find out the common difference between these two numbers. So 19 by 2 minus 31 by 4, this will be 38 minus 31 by 4, 7 by 4, okay. Similarly, we can find here also the difference. So suppose common difference equal to 45 minus 4 minus 19 by 2, 45 minus 38 by 4, this will be again 7 by 4. So our common difference will be, d equal will be 7 by 4. So we found here the d equal to 7 by 4. Now we'll try to find out the 99 term, because now we have the value of a 31 by 4. We found the value of d 7 by 4. We know the value of n is 99. So simply we can put over the these values into our formula, a plus n minus 1 into d. So what will be the value of a 31 by 4 plus n minus 1, n is 99, so 99 minus 1 into d is 7 by 4. So this will be 31 by 4 plus 98 into 7 by 4, okay. This will be 31 by 4 plus 4, this will equivalent to 717 by 4. So 717 by 4 will be the 99 term of this arithmetic progression series. Okay, we'll move to the next question. So we'll solve the question number 10. So question number 10 is saying, how many terms are there in this series? 4, 7, 10, 13, up to 148. So we need to find out how many terms is there in this series. Okay. So we know the value of a equal to 4, d equal to the common difference between two consecutive numbers. So 7 minus 4. Okay. 3, 10 minus 7, again 3, 13 minus 10, again 3. Okay. So 3 is the common difference, and we need to find out. Okay, and TN is given 148. Okay, so we can put into the formula these numbers simply. TN equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So 148 equal to A is 4 plus N minus 1 into D is 3. So we just simplify this equation. Okay, this will be 144. If you move 4 to this side, equal to n minus 1 into 3. We just divide by 3. So that n equal to 49. So total we have 49 term in this series, okay? From 4 to 148, in this series 49 number, total 49 number is there. Now we'll solve the second part of this question. So this is the 0.5, this is 0.553, 0.56 and up to 1.1. So similarly we can solve this question also. So value of a equal to 0.5, value of d equal to, we need to find out the difference between two consecutive series number, okay? So 0.53 minus 0.5 equal to 0.03. Here also the same difference will come, okay? And we know the value of n, tn equal to 1.1. we need to find out the value of n, how many numbers are, total numbers are there in this series. So tn equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So tn is our 1.1 equal to a is 0.5 plus n minus 1 into d is 0.03. Hello everyone, now we will see the question number 11. So which term of AP 1, 4, 7, 10 and up to so on is 52, okay? So last term is given to us. So last term for us is 52, okay? And first term we can see it here, the 1, and common difference we can find out of this series is 3. Here between these two consecutive number is 3. So we can see here first number is a, common difference d equal to 3, and last term we can say l equal to 52, or we can say tn equal to 52, okay? So we know the formula, tn equal to a plus n minus 1 into d, because this is the arithmetic progression series. So we can put the value in this formula. So tn equal to 52 equal to a equivalent to 1 plus n minus 1 into d. D is 3. We have to find out the value of n. So what we will do here, we will just calculate this one. 51 equal to n minus 1 into 3, n minus 1 equal to 51 by 3, so 17, so n equal to 18. So what we found out, so 52 is the 18th term of this arithmetic progression, okay? Got it? So 52 is the 18th term of the given arithmetic progression series, okay? Now we'll move to the next question, the question number 12. So what this question is saying, if the 5th and 6th term of the arithmetic progression series are respectively 6 and 5, find the 11th term of the AP. So we need to find out like 5th term. So what is the 5th term? So we know the tn equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. We will see the 5th term. So t5, what will be a plus n equal to 5, so 5 minus 1, 4 into d. Now what it's saying, the t5 is 5th term is 6, okay? So it's equivalent to 6. Now we'll see the 6th term. So what is the 6th term? It's saying it's equivalent to 5, so it's saying t6 equal to 5. So t6 is a plus n minus 1 into d equal to 5. So a plus n equal to 6, okay? So 6 minus 1, 5, d equal to 5. Now here the equation number 1, here I got the equation number 2. Through these two equations, we can find out the value of the a and d. And after finding the value of the A and D, we can find out easily of the any term. Nth term, my 11th term, my any term, we can find out if we have the value of the A and D. So we'll solve the equation number 1 and equation number 2. So we'll subtract from equation 2 to 1, equation 1. So what it will be? From this equation, we'll subtract this equation. So we'll get the value of D equal to minus 1. We will put this D value into the any of this equation, either 1 or 2. We can get the value of the A. So here I am putting the value of D into the equation number 1. Okay. So A plus 4D equal to 6. So A plus 4 into D equal to minus 1 equal to 6. A plus 4 minus 4 equal to 6. So it will go to the right side. 4 equal to 10. So now we got the value of A equal to 10 and value of D equal to 1. Okay. Now we need to find out the value of 11th term of this arithmetic progression series. So what we will do? D11 equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So N equal to 11. Here we will put the value of these variables. A equal to 10 plus N minus 1, N equal to 11, so 11 minus 1 into D is our minus 1. So it will be 10 plus 10 minus 1 into minus 1. Okay, so it will be 10 minus 10 equal to 0. So 11th term of this arithmetic progression will be 0. So this is the answer. So now we will see the question number 13. So what it's saying, if the Tn represent the nth term of AP, arithmetic progression series, and the equation is given T2 plus T5 minus T3, so that means second term plus fifth term minus third term equal to 10, and similar way second term plus 9th term equal to 17. So find the first term and the common difference of this series. So basically we need to find the A and value of D, okay, of this arithmetic progression series. So what we will do, what will be the our approach? We will simplify this equation and this equation, and we will try to find out the value of the A and D. Okay, so we will take this one. So what is this? T2 plus T5 minus T3 equal to 10. So what is the T2? T2 is nothing but Tn equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So T2 is, this is the value of the N. Okay. So here T2 will be A plus 2 minus 1 into D equivalent to A plus D. Okay. Similar to T5, we can find out A plus 5 minus 1 into D, A plus 4D, okay. And then T3 we can find out A plus N minus 1, 3 minus 1 into D, 2D. So these are the value of T2, T5 and T3. Now we will put these value into this equation, okay. So what will be the our final equation? T2 is A plus D plus T5, A plus 4D, then minus T3 minus A plus 2D equal to 10. So what after simplification of this equation, what will be our value? A plus 3D equal to 10. So this is our equation number 1. Okay. Now we'll find out the similar kind of equation from the this, okay, term. So we will try to solve this. So T2 plus T9 equal to 17. Similar way we can find out here the T2 and T9 value after putting the nth term into this equation. So T2 will be T2 equivalent to A plus n minus 1, 2 minus 1 into T, A plus D plus T9 equal to A plus n minus 1, 9 minus 1. So we will see the question number 14. Find the 10th term from the end of the arithmetic progression. And this is the arithmetic progression is given to us 4, 9, 14, not to 2, 54. So we need to find out the 10th term from the end, okay? Not from the beginning. So from the end we need to find out the 10th term. Okay? So there is two approach. First thing, we can reverse this, okay, series. In the beginning we can make it first term 254 and then up to nth term is 4, and then try to find out the 10th term from the beginning, okay? Fine, otherwise we can just find out the 10th term from the end, okay? Both way we can achieve this one. So we will try to find out, so how many numbers is there, how many terms is there in this, okay, in this series. So Tn equal to A plus n minus 1 into T, okay? So 254 equal to A4 plus n minus 1 into D is 5, okay? So 250 equal to n minus 1 into 5, n minus 1 equal to 50, n equal to 51. So total 51 term is there, okay? So we can find out here, so n minus r plus 1 f term, okay, from beginning, okay, we can find out the equivalent to the nth term from the end. Fine. So n is our 51 minus r is 10 term, 10 plus 1. Okay. This equivalent to 42th term from beginning. So 42th term from the beginning is equivalent to the 10th term from the end of this series, will be same. Okay, we will see it. So we can find out the 42th term. So A plus n minus 1, 4 plus n minus 1, 42 minus 1 into D. D is our 5. Okay. So 4 plus 41 into 5. 4 plus this much, so 209, okay, 209 term is. So we will see the question number 15. Determine the arithmetic progression whose third term is 5 and seventh term is 9. Okay, so third term is saying T3 equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. So T3 is equivalent to 5 equal to A plus n minus 1 into D, and n is 3, 5 equal to A plus 3 minus 1 to D. This is the equation number 1. We got it from this third term, and 7th term is 9. So similar way you will write the T9, T7 term, A plus n minus 1 into T. So T7 equivalent to 9 equal to A plus n is 7 term, okay? So 7 minus 1, 16. This is the equation number 2. We need to solve the equation number 1 and equation number 2. So I will subtract from equation number 2 to equation number 1. I will get the value is 4D equal to 9 minus 5, 4, D equal to 1. So I will put the value of D into any of equation 1 or 2 and I can get the value of A. So A plus 2D equal to 5. So A equal to 3. So now I got the value of A and D. I can just write the arithmetic progression series here, right? So how the series come? A plus D, A plus 2D, okay, up to N. So A is 3. Next will be A plus D, 4. Then 5, okay, then 6, 1 is the common difference between this up to m. So this is our arithmetic progression series. Hi. So we will see the question number 16. Find the 31st term of the arithmetic progression series whose 10th term is 38 and 16th term is 74. Okay. So here the two equation we can find out from these two equation, and we can solve the equation and find out the value of a and b, and then we can find easily value of the 10th term, that means 31st term. Okay. So first we will take this one. 10th term is 38. So pn equal to a plus n minus 1 into t. So t10 equal to a plus n minus 1 into d is 38. Okay, so a plus 9d equal to 38. This is the question number, equation number 1. Now similar way we will take the this information and try to create the other equation. Okay, so 16th term is t16 equal to a plus n minus 1 16 minus 1 into d equal to 74, then a plus 15d equal to 74. This is the equation number 2. From the equation number 2 and 1, we can find out the value of the a and d. Okay, and after finding the value of the a and d, we can find out the value of the 31st term. So what we will do by solving the equation number 2 and 1, 6d equal to 74 minus 38, okay, 36, so d equal to 6, okay, and put this value of d into any of equation, okay, we can find the value of the a, so a plus 9 into 6 equal to 38, a plus 54 equal to 38, so a equal to 38 minus 54 equal to 16. Okay, so a equal to minus 16. So now we got the value of a and d, we can find out the value of the 31st term. T31st equal to a plus 31st minus 1 into d. We put the value of a here, a is minus 16 plus 30 into d is 6. Minus 16 plus 180, okay, and then it will be 164. Okay, so we move to the next question. Now we will see the question number 17. So which term of the series 21, 18, 15, this is the series, is 81, minus 81. So which term will be minus 81 of the this series? Okay. Can any term of this series is 0? If yes, then find out the which term is 0 of this series. Okay, so there is two question. So first we will find out first. Okay. So here value of a equal to 21 and value of b equal to 18 minus 21 minus 3. Here 15 minus 18 equal to minus 3. So value of d equal to minus 3. Okay. So we will find out that. So tn equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. This is the formula of finding the nth term of the arithmetic progression series. Okay. So tn value is given here 81 minus 81. Equal to a 21 plus n minus 1 into b. B is minus 3. Okay. So here we will move this value to the left side. So it will be minus 102 equal to minus 3 into n minus 1. Okay. Minus minus you can remove it. So 102 equal to b into n minus 1. So n minus 1 equal to basically n minus 1 equal to 34 So n equal to 35. Now 35th term will be the value of 35th term will be minus 81. Okay. So if we solve the first part of this question, now we will see the second part. If any term is of this series is 0 or not, so we consider the any term of this series is 0. Okay. So dn equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. What we will do? We will need to find out the value of n, which nth term will be 0. So tn equal to 0 equal to a 21 plus n minus 1, okay, into d is minus 3. So it's saying which term will be 0. Okay, so I put it, term is 0. So nth term, suppose I am considering the nth term will be 0, okay, and I am just putting the value of a and d from this series. Okay, so it will be minus 21 equal to minus 3 and minus 1. Okay, so this will be 7 equal to minus minus cancel, 3 7 is 21 equal to n minus 1. Okay, n equal to 8. So 8th term will be 0 of this series. Okay, so this is the answer of this question. Now we move to the next question. So what question number 18 is saying? An arithmetic progression consists of the 60 term. So total term is 60, n equal to 60. 60 term is there. If the first and last term is 7 and 125, so it's saying a equal to 7 and last term is 125. Okay. So the series will be like AP series will be like 7 something something, and this is total 60 term. Last term will be 125. So this is our series. Okay. Now it's saying now we find the value of the 34th term. Okay. So what we'll say, the 60th term, this will be the 60th term. Okay. This is the 60th term. 125 is the 60th term. Okay. So now we will see T60, Tn, A plus N minus 1 into T. So T60, what is the value of T60? 125 A 7 plus N minus 1. We know the value of N is 60 minus 1. Okay, into T. So here what 125 minus 7 equal to 59 D. Okay, and this will be 118 equal to 59 D. Okay, so D equal to 118 by 59 equivalent to 2. Okay, so D value of D is 2, value of A equal to 7. So now easily we can find out the value 31st term of this arithmetic progressing series, right? So T31st equal to A plus N minus 1 into T. T31st equal to 31 term equal to A is 7 plus 31 minus 1, 30 into D is 2, 7 plus 60 equal to 67. So 31st term will be 67 of this arithmetic progression series. Okay. So now we will see the question number 19. What it is saying, sum of the 4th and 8th term of arithmetic progression series is 24. Okay. And sum of the 6th and 10th term of the same arithmetic progression is 34. Fine. So find the first 3 terms of the arithmetic progression series. So here it's saying the 4th and 8th term is 24 and 6th and 10th term is 34. So now we can find out with these two equations, and we can get the value of A and D, and after that we can create the series. That this will be the our approach. Okay. So first we'll write the 4th term, Tn equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So what it's saying, fourth term t4 equal to a plus 4 minus 1 into t, okay, and t8th similarly, t8th equal to a plus 8 minus 1 into d, a plus 3d, here it will be a plus 7d, okay. Now it's saying that t4 plus t8 equal to 24. This equation is saying t4 and t8 equal to 24. So what I will do? So a plus 3d plus a plus 7d equal to 24. So 2a plus 10d equal to 24. A plus 5d equal to 12. Just I divide the two from both sides. Okay. This is my question number 1. Okay. Now similar way, I can create the equation number 2 from this information, okay, from this information. So 6 term plus 10 term, sum of the 6 term plus 10 term is 34. So sum of 6 term t6 plus t10 equal to 34, okay. So t6 is a plus 6 minus 1 into t, 5t. Plus 10 term is a plus n minus 1, 10 minus 1 into t, 90 equal to 34. So 2a plus 14d equal to 34, divide by 2 from both sides, a plus 7d equal to 70. Okay, this is my equation 2. Now from the equation 2 and 1, we can find the value of the a and t. Okay, so just subtract from 2. 1, okay, so I will get the value of 2d equal to 5, d equal to 5 by 2, okay, and I put the value of d into any of the equation 1 or 2, I can easily find the value of the a, okay, so a plus, I am putting the value of d into equation number 2, 7 into 5 by, okay, 2 equal to 17, so a equal to 34 minus 35 by 2, okay. So a equal to minus 1 by 2. So this is the value of a and this is the value of d, okay. Now easily I can create the series, arithmetic progression series, right. So our arithmetic progression series is a plus d, a plus 2d, okay, a plus 3d, and we just put the value of these two and find out the value of the first three terms of the arithmetic progression series. Okay, fine, we will move to the next question. So now we will move to the question number 20. So it's saying about if the third term of the arithmetic progression series is 5 and 7th term is 9, then find the value of the 17th term. So we need to find out the value of 17th term, that means we should know the value of the a and d, then we can find out the 17th term, fine. So from these two information, we need to find out the value of a and d, okay. So it's saying the third term is 5, okay. So we can say like t3 equal to a plus n minus 1 into t, okay. t3 is saying 5 equal to a plus third term 3 minus 1 into d, so 5 equal to a plus 2d. This is my equation number 1. Now similar way, we will find out, okay, from this information, okay, we can create the equation number 2, and after that we will further proceed, okay. So 7th term t7 equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So t7, what it is saying, t7 equal to 9 equal to a plus 16, okay. This is my equation number 2. Now I will solve equation number 1 and 2 and find the value of the a and d, okay. So what will be the value of 4d subtract from 2 to 1? 4d equal to 4, d equal to 1. Put the value of the d into any of them. So I will put the value of d into equation 2. So 9 equal to a plus 6, a equal to 3. So now I got the value of the a and u,
okay,
and then I can find out the value of any term of this arithmetic progression series, not only the 17th, any term we can find out. So this is the 17th term in this question is saying. So t17 equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay. So a is 3 plus 17.